So, a few weeks ago, Namibia's finance minister delivered the 2019 budget speech to the National Assembly, something he's required to do at least once a year by the Constitution. The budget speech always draws significant media attention in the weeks leading up to it and immediately after. But do you really understand its real life, day-to-day implications on you, your family, and the country as a whole? Well, in this video, we'll summarize everything you need to know about Budget Speech 2019 and what it means for you and Namibia as a whole. The first thing you need to understand is the budgeting process is a part of a bigger tool that government uses to influence the country's economy, which is called fiscal policy. This involves adjusting its spending levels and the tax rates that it charges to people and organizations, and gets really complex. But we don't need to worry ourselves with all of that, because we know what the budgeting process is supposed to do, which is to better the economy, which means increasing productivity and consequently creating jobs. But has it though? It's no secret that the Namibian economy has taken a massive hit the last 2 years. So is the government and its fiscal policies to blame? Well, that's a question for another video. But the first big theme in this year's budget speech is that we've steadied what was undoubtedly a sinking economy. Although Namibia's economy continued to contract in 2018 by between 0.2 and 0.5%, that's still less severe than the contraction of 0.9% in 2017. Growth in government debt levels also slowed to an annual average of 11.2% over the past 2 years, as opposed to an annual average of 30.1% over the 3 years before that. This significant reduction in the growth of government debt has coincided with an equally noticeable reduction in the budget deficit, which decreased from 8.1% to 4% in the past 4 years. The budget deficit is the amount by which a government's expenditure exceeds its income. So intuitively, it's easy to understand why government has needed to borrow less as the deficit has narrowed. Over the past 3 years, government revenues have grown by a significant 3.8%, relative to a much smaller growth of 0.4% in expenditure. On the surface, this sounds great, but the next part of this video will explain why this is not necessarily the case for Namibia. The second big theme of the 2019 budget speech is that we are by no means out of the woods just yet. Namibia needs significant economic growth, now rather than later, to deal with issues such as its high youth unemployment rate, which according to the latest labor force survey, has risen to 46.1%. If the persistent recession Namibia currently finds itself in has taught us one thing, it's that an over-reliance on government is not a good thing for our economy. A healthy and growing private sector is every bit as necessary for Namibia as a well-run and efficient government. A large portion of the economic growth that Namibia experienced before the onset of the recession was due to an unsustainable level of government spending that ultimately saw government debt levels balloon. This is part of the reason we can't rely on government spending to drive economic growth for Namibia now, because it's simply not possible given the government's current financial position. According to the World Bank, Namibia had the fifth largest tax to GDP ratio in the world in 2016. Higher than that of much bigger economies such as the United States and the United Kingdom, and that of much faster growing African counterparts such as Rwanda. Therefore, increasing the tax burden of an already heavily taxed private sector, which is also under severe economic pressure due to the recession, is not the best of ideas. And even if government were to use taxation to raise additional revenues, very little of that would find its way to the development-related expenditure needed to grow Namibia's economy. For one, Namibia has the fifth largest public wage to GDP ratio in the world. So a significant portion of any additional taxes raised will fund what has become a stubbornly large wage bill, and much smaller portions will fund development. This is evidenced by the expected total personnel expenditure budgeted for the financial year 2019-2020. Of 29.9 billion Namibian dollars versus a 7.9 billion development budget in the same financial year. So, in summary, government's efforts have been largely successful in improving its financial position and steadying the economy over the last few years, and should be audibly commended. But now, If Namibia is to generate the type of economic growth required to significantly improve living standards and create jobs, the government will need to put a little more faith in its own people and go out of its way to create a conducive environment for business and investment in order for the private sector to contribute significantly to the growth needed to transform Namibia. Will it though? If the tax amendments suggested in the budget speech are anything to go by, such as the introduction of a 10% dividends tax for dividends paid to Namibian residents, it seems the government is adamant in its efforts to focus on improving its finances and fund the economic growth itself, which we think will prove challenging in the foreseeable future. Do you agree with our opinions? Let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the bell icon below to be notified when the latest episodes of the Foster Digital Education Show are released. Also, follow our Facebook and Twitter pages where we share some more exclusive content. And remember, learn, connect, grow.